hey, this is the training video for the wash station. So we're gonna go over the setup right now. What we have here is our new Metro rack that's turned horizontally. I have my 8-inch full plastic hotel pans here to put my wash produce in. I have one Slim Jim for trash and one Slim Jim for compost. Then I have my recycling and trash part right here. Next is setting up the machine. It's made of these white pieces, perforated plastic, and gray divider. So half the sink is already set up. The most important thing are these white pieces. So they actually fit in the machine, which you can't see on the inside right now, but they fit the contour of the machine. So this little piece goes in the back ledge where there's a little part that comes in like this. I don't know how else to describe it. And it sits in the bottom like this, all right? So when I put these in the machine, like so, I put these in the machine like this, I'm then gonna slide in this plastic piece. It goes like this, all right? So what's gonna happen is when we turn the machine on, there's gonna be jets that push the water down this way, and it's gonna circulate a tumbling motion. So when we put produce in there, it cleans it. Right? So the most important thing to make this machine work is that all these little metal knobs here are magnetic, right? So they have to line up with the machine from end to end, touching each other when the machine turns on. Right, so I put these in real quick. Plastic pieces. And then we can operate the machine with or without these, but they separate the stations into sections like that. Alright, step two, we're gonna fill up the machine. So I wanna make sure that I have at least a quarter of chemical in the antimicrobial wash, right? This is a lactic acid-based wash. It helps clean the vegetables. If there's any kind of contamination coming off the farm, that will make that safe. So it removes physical residue and also any microbial residue, right? So the only way we can fill the sink is not water through this nozzle. It has to be through this dispenser right here. So I'm gonna turn on the bottom. Let knob to close the drain, then I'm gonna start filling. This is gonna take 15 to 20 minutes, so it has to get done right when we come in and it's gonna turn on. So when we come back, it's gonna be filled, and we're gonna test the chemical pollution. So what I'm aiming for, one last note, is that there's this little line on the side of the sink. The wash, the antimicrobial wash has to be filled up to that. If it's any lower than that, it could damage the machine. There's not enough liquid in there when we actually turn it over. So we're filling up to that line. So now my sink is filled up this line right here with antimicrobial wash. Some of the things that I forgot to bring out of the earlier part are the two wash baskets, cutting board, and a chef's knife. Right? So after the sink's filled up, I want to check the dilution of the antimicrobial wash in here to make sure it's at the proper dilution. So I'm going over to where the antimicrobial wash is stored, right here. I'm going to take a test strip out, and you have to read the directions. It's saying dip this in the solution for 1 to 2 seconds. 1, 2, and pull out, and then you're matching the color. The color needs to match what's in the box right there. And to do the proper solution, you need to record this down. Second of all, if you're ever confused, the instructions for the manufacturer's recommendations are right here on the side of the wash station. It has the dilution and the contact. Right? So when washing the vegetables, it has to be a 90-second contact time, mandatory for this microbial wash. Right. Keep that in mind. So over here are my gloves. I'm handling produce. You need to have gloves on at all times. So there's three types of vegetables we're usually washing. One are really hardy, like carrots. There's one that are semi-hardy and delicate, and then stuff that's really delicate. So just because it's going in this machine, it doesn't mean that it needs to be tumbled per se. So if this is a heavier duty vegetable that is really dirty, we're gonna tumble it. Something like you might tumble it for a couple minutes, but then it just sits in the antimicrobial wash for the rest of the 90 seconds. If it's something more delicate like lettuce, agitate it and then let it sit in the antimicrobial wash, right? So to have this thing to work is, if you're turning on the machine, pull this knob right here, and it pulls everything in a circular motion, right? So we're putting the vegetables in there for 90 seconds, and when we're ready to take it out, we're using these catch baskets. So the catch basket goes into the liquid, then the vegetable tumbles into the catch basket, we're pulling it up, we're turning it sideways. While that's draining, we're catching other vessels, this other catch basket. And you're working in the system. So essentially, it shouldn't need to go into the wash itself. And you're able to pull up a lot more than you can. So we're in a demo carrots right now. Time per case is 5 minutes, and that's with buffer added into it. So to put this in the wash solution, maybe 10 seconds, 15 seconds. For it to wash, it needs to be 90 seconds. And how I know it's really 90 seconds, I have a clock on the burning that I'm looking at to make sure it tumbles for 90 seconds or sits for 90 seconds. And taking it out, it's maybe 30 seconds or a minute top. So ideally, I could do this wash and case in maybe a minute and a half, 2 minutes, but our target time is 5 minutes, so it's buffer. So I got carrots here. Rip the bag open. And we're going to distribute it amongst the bags. Now you don't want to overload the sink, because then the water will come out on the drain board. Not a big deal. That's why that line is really crucial. Right? Let's go with my trash. We'll turn off my tumbler. And I'm going to look at my clock and make sure it tumbles for 90 seconds or 60 with 90 seconds. So you can see the carrots are going around in a circle, getting washed and agitated. The carrots have been tumbling for 90 seconds. I'm ready to take them out. So I'm going to put one of my catch pans in. Put this one in. I try to give them spacing. So I wait a second, and I pull it up, boom, vegetables. While that's draining, I'm pulling this other catch up, letting that drain. So now I'm coming back to this one, it's already pretty much drained, it's going into a clean, full pan. I'm back at the same reservoir to catch anything that I didn't catch before. Going back and forth. Now when you get less vegetables in there, when you're pulling it out, you want to slide it forward to capture everything against the front. So that's clear. So our policy is every single thing we cook with goes through the antimicrobial wash. It's one of our steps in our food safety policy. If it's in a full pan, it's been washed. So you can't put anything that hasn't been washed in a full pan. All right, so ready for my next case. If I was working with a smaller case, those are 50 pounds of carrots. I could put apples in here, or 10 pounds of apples in something small. Here, let that wash. As I'm loading this thing with something else, by the time I finish loading these 2 bags, I can come back here and then pull out the apples as that's washing. Right? Now we're moving on to something more delicate like mint. So this is delicate. So one of the rules in this machine is you have to take off all rubber bands and all sticker before it goes in this machine. Rubber bands, if you don't take the rubber bands off, they'll get lost in the machine and then get tumbled inside an herb. And then some of you are going to find that in falafel because they're not going to see it. It's going to get blended up and it's become a hazard. Right? So before I wash this, I take off the rubber band. It goes in the trash can, not on the drain board because it'll get washed back. And I'm taking them in, hand agitating it, and letting it sit there. Because it has to sit in there for 90 seconds. But I'm working all the dirt out. I'm working all the dirt out by agitating it in my hand, right? So I'm physically cleaning it. Then it needs to sit in there for 90 seconds to make sure that the wash is doing its job. So now we're working with something like box, right? When you're done with the box, you're going to break it down right on the spot, like that, and you're going to lay it flat on the trash cart behind you. So cardboard boxes go on the back broken down, and underneath is plastic and recycling. What you don't want to do at any time in this station is have anything on these white bins, produce, boxes, nothing, right? These are all dry goods, and you don't want anything on this back ledge back here where it is, right? That's where the customers come in here. If we stack things up, customers can't see what's going inside. So, all right, now these are been in here for 90 seconds. I'm gonna take them out, put them on the drain board. And anything delicate like this that I wash or put in the solution, I'll leave here for maybe 10, 15 seconds, and then all that streams off the fish, and I put it in the container that needs to go by. Now, at this point, my water can get kind of dirty with leaves, basically these worms, and you don't want a lot of fruit. Just empty baskets in here. You can turn the machine on again, 5, 10 seconds per bag. It'll clean the water out for you, all the extra herbs and whatever else is in the water. So when you put your next item in there, it gets nice and clean, right? There's also an insert of the screen that you can put in here for the final start. Lastly, guys, there's a checklist over here that's posted on the wall, and it shows the wash list order, right? It's very important that we're feeding production. This is the very beginning where production begins. So we have to know an exact wash order to make sure none of the other stations are waiting on us as a team, right? So if you're confused on what to do first, refer to the wash order. It shows what to wash first and what station it's for, so you can call out if you're confused that person anytime. That's posted on the wall. All right, thanks, guys.